afternoon. I'd like to thank the organizing committee for inviting me. I'm going to talk about nitric oxide production and where do we think it's produced. Is it from the upper airway or from the lower airway in children? This study has been performed at McGill University at Montreal Children's Hospital. So what we are looking for, nitric oxide have been produced from endothelial cells of the airway, and all of you know that nitric oxide is a smooth muscle relaxant, especially in the pulmonary vasculature. And this has been used as a marker of inflammatory process of the airways. So if you have an asthmatic patient and you think he's probably an excessive patient, if you measure exhaled nitric oxide, probably is going to be high. So our question is, where is it produced? Is it from lower airway or from upper airway in normal children? And it's been postulated as a marker of inflammatory process of any disease. But the problems that has been most of the measurements that have been done, especially in kids and adults, is being produced probably mainly from upper airways. So what is our objective of this study? To measure the normal exhaled nitric oxide and to get a reference for this number. What is the normal for exhaled nitric oxide in kids? And where is it produced? Is it from lower airways or from upper airways? So we get 50 normal children. They went to elective surgery, excluding airway surgery because it might affect nitric oxide production, or patient who had recently viral illness for the last few weeks before their surgery. This patient went for elective surgery like inguinal hernia repair, umbilical hernia repair, or other minor surgeries. So what we did three measurements of exhaled nitric oxide. First, upon induction of anesthesia. Second, measurement of either if they get intubated through the endotracheal tubes or if they get laryngeal mask airways. And the third, during emerge, after end of the surgery, and trying to compare the nitric oxide levels from these type of patients. This is the LMA that we used during surgery. So what happened that measurement of exhaled nitric oxide in preschool children and induction of anesthesia was 10.23, and emerge it was around 8.35 per million. You could not see major difference between the pre and post. But what about the intubated groups? The level was very low, 0.75. So we think most of exhaled nitric oxide have been produced from the upper airway, not from the lower airway. What about laryngeal mask airway? Is around 2.6. So we think that probably there is some contaminations because laryngeal mask airway will not give you a complete seal for airway. So probably there have been some contamination from the upper airway that was giving you this result. This is a population of the group, either intubated group and laryngeal mask group. And this is an easy decision who decide which group we will go. Like you could see smaller kids, they usually go for intubation. You know, older kids, they will go for laryngeal mask airway. So in two groups, intubated and laryngeal mask airway. And there have been probably no difference, you know, in regard to the genders or the weight probably is higher in laryngeal mask airway because we understand that probably they will tolerate more of laryngeal mask airway, not the smaller kid where they need to be intubated for their surgery. And this is what happened. This is the mask or pre-anesthesia exhaled nitric oxide is normal. So we think probably the normal exhaled nitric oxide production in children is around 10. And this is the LMA, and this is the endothecal tube. It's very low level of exhaled nitric oxide production from the lower airway. And this is the mask, which is exhaled nitric oxide measurement. So in conclusion, that we think that most of exhaled nitric oxide is produced from the upper airway in preschool children. And the lower airway constitution of exhaled nitric oxide is very low. So in the probably in the future, this study is going to help us if you get an intubated patient with acute lung injury and you measure his exhaled nitric oxide, probably is going to be very high because of a lot of inflammatory process going on. And the laryngeal mask airway will not, doesn't completely isolate the upper airways. And probably the current mask condition probably having some contamination of the upper airways, so we need to be aware of that. I'd just like to thank my colleague with me that did the study. And thank you.
Thank you so much. Any questions? When people don't have questions to say that they may not understand, it was well presented.
I want to know that is the, you are talking about the inflammatory nitric oxide. Well, there's a normal, healthy trachea. Is there any production of nitric oxide?
You mean in the trachea?
Yeah.
We think it's very low, so it's going to be a good tool for as inflammatory marker. So if you get somebody who has intubated, at least now we know the normal exhaled nitric oxide in somebody who is from his lower airway. So if you had somebody with acute lung injury or severe asthma who's been intubated, exhaled nitric oxide is going to be very high. But in normal kids, it's very low, minimal production, mostly the production from his upper airway. Very good. So at least now we know the normal level of exhaled nitric oxide around 10. So if you get somebody with exhaled nitric oxide of 20, 25 or so, that we know there is some inflammatory is going on, either because of allergic rhinitis or sinusitis or asthma or whatever reason. So it's give us a normal value of this kid because there have been a lot of published studies about normal measurement of exhaled nitric oxide.
So you are suggesting that it will be a complementary to C-reactive protein to see what is happening in the sinuses or in the...
Yes, it will help. It will help you. There is an inflammatory process going on with the upper.